We were born of mothers who smoked and drank. Our cribs were cut. Been told that, hey, if you'll hook me up, I'm going to release all the footage for J6 to the public so everybody can see the truth. And yet here we are with this one now getting in, and we still ain't seen everything. Stars are supposed to be facing on a patch style or a hat or something a certain way. Yeah. Into the wind, that's the whole idea. You know, he wasn't for the diapers on your face and the forced jab. So there's some good stuff, but it's like everything, dude. You see the blatant disrespect for the flag. And so then that fuels up any deviation. Strategically place the Mohabs to go down about 200 yards to shatter all them tunnels.
If you had to live in a painting, what would the landscape be?
If I had to live in a painting, it would be a rural woodsy cabin.
What is the first car that you actually paid for yourself, and how much was it?
Well, the original frame was a 72 Ford F-100. And I paid $350 for it, if I remember. And then pieced the rest of it together out of a salvage yard. Every week when I would get paid, I would go to the salvage yard and buy a piece or two and slowly put it together.
What is the last song that you listened to?
If I Ain't Here Tomorrow, Toast and Jam.
What is your favorite chore?
My favorite chore? Mowing the grass.
If you had one food that you could plant that was guaranteed for the rest of your life, which one plant would that be?
Ooh, potatoes.
Who would you want to be your mentor? Anybody from history, religious, fictional, factual, doesn't matter, living, dead.
Ooh, man. Man, that's a hard one there. Davy Crockett. He survived, dude. He literally went. He had to go for reinforcements, and he literally went barefoot, came, showed up at the fort finally, damn near dying of starvation, shredded feet, but he made it through hostile areas and everything. It's in the Battle of California. That's just one of those that has always stood out and struck me like, dude, this is flintlock shit. This is bow and arrow time. This is nothing but fortitude is what makes you get through. There ain't no magical technology tool that you get to use.
Right.
And that dude just kicked ass. It's hard though there, because there is with the Alamo and shit. Sam Houston was pretty bad mofo. Cassius Clay, like I showed this morning, was pretty bad mofo.
If you could change your legal government name, would you, and what would you change it to?
Nah, I would ride with what I got. It meant something to my mom when she gave it to me.
If you could have the answer to any one single question, not the meaning of life, what question would that be?
What's the secret to true peace?
What would the name of your autobiography be?
What would be the title of it?
Yep.
That's all, folks.
If there were 10 songs that made up the soundtrack of your life, what would 3 of those songs be?
So 3 songs that tell my life.
It's the soundtrack for your whole life in 10 songs, but name just 3 of them.
Bucky Covington, A Different World.
We were born of mothers who smoked and drank. Our cribs were covered in lead.
Eagle, 7 Bridges Road. represent that. Black and blue, five finger.
What was the last movie, book, or song that made you glassy-eyed, teared up, almost teared up, got you in your feelers?
Damn, I just watched it. When the Game Stood Still.
Particular scene. Where
something bad happens to you, or something challenging confronts you.
When they lost the series.
Climb into your head and hear what that voice is saying to you.
Crushing moment on them, and they just kind of
saying, "Oh no, we lost the streak."
The coach went through a serious medical deal. He was kind of coming.
About yourselves.
And the Game Stood Tall. I'll have to look in the foot. When the Game Stood Tall. Yeah, I think that's the name of it. I got it actually on my phone. I got it on my tablet. I watched that. It's probably one of the ones that just kind of gets me.
Name something bad that started off bad that you thought was just, this is just pure shit, but turned out to actually be a good thing.
So do I fill out one of these as a NA, if not applicable, or?
Hey, if it doesn't apply, it doesn't apply.
Yeah, I guess. So something that
was bad, that started off bad, but turned out to be a good thing.
I can't think of nothing. To be honest, most shit I kind of seen is coming as bad. It ended up as bad. It just...
Right. not everything has to have an answer. You're good. You're good. If you can meet anyone, living or dead, for 12 hours, who would it be and what would you do?
Ooh, anybody for 12 hours.
Same applies. Religious, fictional, non-fictional, you know, however it goes.
Oh, well, I mean, Jesus would be cool.
What would you do with Jesus for 12 hours?
I would just hang on every word. I would ask just to tell me whatever, and then I would just listen.
Right. Just hold church for 12 hours?
Yeah. I mean, man, that's 12 hours with the Creator. I can't even begin to think of what I would think of when I just had that opportunity. It would just be like, I don't know. I'll just there for 12 hours would probably do me fine.
If you could instantly learn one skill like magic, what would it be and how would you use it?
Oh, like right here, right now? If I could just like, bam, hit something and learn it out the gate. Would be like CAD drawing.
What is that?
Engineering CAD drawing. So designing schematics and CAD parts to go CNC. So you design the part and all the packaging.
You're the man that makes the machine, pretty much.
That tells the tool which way to go. That's your CAD. So the machine has the tool in the head. The CAD guy's the right the path and draws the map.
If you were in jail right now, who would your first phone call to be to? Or would you even make a phone call?
Yeah, I'd call my wife. Just to tell her bye.
What is in your opinion, the biggest single crisis facing America right now? One thing that's above all the rest.
Man. Lack of self-accountability.
So if you were immortal for a year, what kind of lifestyle would you have? What would you do with yourself?
Oh, well, shit, son. I'd be cleaning up some shit.
It's not saying you can't get arrested. Remember, it's not saying you can't get arrested. It's just saying you can't die.
which means you can't hold me. So that, which means you're not going to arrest me.
Right.
So that means I'm fixing to clean up some shit.
straight Batman type shit on.
Yeah, shit. I might even be. What was that? What was the one where? Was it Vin Diesel did the deal whenever he had the little fucked up thing about him there, and then at the end he kind of was contained his little
Bloodshot.
Yeah, that's it. If it's like, well, if I ain't got to die, well, hell, we fix and get it on because I'm gonna clean up some shit then because you can.
Yeah. What was the incident or the moment you realized that, oh, I'm grown up, I'm an adult now?
Probably like the for real, like, because kind of when I was in, when I signed, got on the bus and went to the Army, I thought I was, but it wasn't until after the door shut on the second trip to the penitentiary later, a little bit later in life, is when it really hit me then, because it's like, oh yeah. This is where we're at.
If you had two unconditional executive orders that automatically mandated, what would they be?
If I had two unconditional executive orders, mm-hmm. Like, what do you mean?
Like the president has. He can sign an executive order. Boom.
Oh, so like if I could just sign two myself? Damn, man, that's kind of like a trick question almost. Have you been watching interviews from Trump or something?
What a lot of
people. Because it's like, I feel like I'm fixing to mimic him because I'm going to go, I'm going to close the border and drill, baby, drill.
All acceptable answers.
That's what he had said. And I thought about that. I went, wait a minute, I'm going to repeat the same thing he just said. Right. Yeah, that's what Trump, but yeah. Well, I'd close the border, yeah. Because I don't think you could wrap up the rest of that clusterfuck in one executive order. So about the only next big thing you could do, I think, closing the border would be to then open up the lease of the lands and let them drill.
Well, see, wouldn't that kind of go hand in hand? Because if you think about it, if you close the border, that could include all foreign trade, import, export. So you could, if you close the border, in essence, closing the border would force the country to have to drill because you got nothing coming in.
Well, that's so true.
One could feed the other.
Well, if I could do that, then I would figure, I don't know how I could word that second one to wrap up, because I would definitely be on the three-letter agencies and addressing all that and shutting that shit down. Way too many committees, way too many agencies, way too many little tentacles of this branch. You need to start cutting that shit off. I don't know how you do that in one executive order, but I could come up with a damn stack pretty damn quick.
It's all in the way you word it. If you were completely alone in the woods with nothing but what you got on right now, what's the one tool that you would wish you had with you?
Well, if it's what I have on me now, now that I'm holding the more important part, So like just if all, like literally what I have, so like if I'm all I'm holding there's this, then I wouldn't have phone, I wouldn't have nothing in front of, like nothing, right? Just
right. What's in your pockets? What's in your hands at the moment? What you're wearing?
Well, shit, and it's up there. So I'd have to say, I guess my knife.
Village, nomad, or lone wolf?
Village, nomad, or lone wolf. If it was right here, right now, like we're having this conversation, then probably going to be end up being a mix of lone wolf nomad, I think, at first. No offense to you or anybody that hears this later on, but
no, that's so far, that's been the number one answer, is basically nomad gets justified because it's, you can go off in the woods for 7-8 months, do your own thing, be left alone, and then come back to the market, the bazaar to trade and do your bullshitting for a couple weeks and get the fuck back out. That would count as nomadic.
Well, see, and I could kind of see a village mentality if I was like closer to quite a few people to where when that happened, then it kind of becomes a consolidation. Then I could see the village kind of thing on the small scale, but the whole village, like where I'm at, no.
30 years after shift, whatever shift may be, what is your ideal government? What does America look like in your image 30 years after the collapse?
A hardworking public that raises kids where we have an educational level and then we actually have a hands-on trade skill level. We might even have a military level by then with the patriotism as a nationality kind of thing and exercise and just let's learn how to do this. A small government just tending to international stuff and that and states tending to their own. That's what would be nice to see. And then you just kind of let the area settle out where they're going to. You know, if that's the majority, but nobody has an overall impact on nobody else. Do you, yeah. Boo? No, and if you know what we lose, you know, you lose 100 million because of it, you just do it. You gotta have to thin it out, but we're become so fat and complacent and so reliant on somebody to put in a work. Our imagination of starvation is meaning we don't get to go out to eat to the restaurant. And it's like, but there's still a pack of ramen noodles. Oh my God, who would eat that? There's the problem. That comment gets made. Right. You know, we used to make fun and we get told kids were starving in Ethiopia, but we literally are just, dude, think right. about
we
it.
We waste more than most countries even manufacture.
Dude, we feed our hogs. People feed scraps to their animals more than some countries get. Think about that. We literally have farms and swine farms and shit that literally dump out tons of waste that like right now over there in Gaza Strip, I'm sure they would love some food.
Right. What is one book everybody should read or own?
Man, almost feels like a, well, I feel the Bible. Probably more as close to the original text as you can get, which is like one that I'm shooting for and that I read online. It's called the Scriptures. It's about the most accurate translation from some of the original wording. But the Bible, and it's not even, I believe, yes, but it's not even just that. It's just if the messaging of it, and you know, it's always been known as the book of books, rather it's romance, war,
number one selling book in history.
It's always been, you know, and so, and when you look at that, which the only thing I've always been impressed with the compilation of it, you know, just the different authors, different continents, different time frames, but yet one talks about the other that happens 500 years later, go figure. And it's, right. There's some impressive stuff, but I just the Bible, the core.
If you only had one gun forever, that's the only gun you would ever be able to use, what would it be? Right now, before shift, after shift, in shift, doesn't matter. One gun forever.
Oh, damn. I guess a shotgun. Probably a 10 gauge.
Do you have any other social media like Twitter, X, Rumbles, whatever, any of that nonsense?
I do that. I got X.
X.
I follow like the Coast Guard, the Central Command, the Pacific Fleet, Army, Marines, commands, some of the senators, Josh Hawley's and stuff like that to do it. Now Tucker Carlson. It's the Clucking Alamo. With no G though. It's the Clucking Alamo.
Gotcha.
It's even got a little batshit crazy looking rooster as my icon.
When you're 80 years old, what do you want your environment to be? What is your dream retirement goal for when you're, okay, I literally don't have to do anything but sit on this porch all day?
Oh, man. I wish that was a cabin in the woods with a creek in front of it.
Fishing for the rest of your life?
Or just sit there and look and watch it and listen to it.
If you could have any animal right now that's alive as a pet, that is 100% your best friend, it's trained, it listens to you, what would it be?
Ooh. A mongoose.
That would tear some shit up.
Pretty sneaky and vicious little fuckers.
That is I did not expect that answer. It works just fine. Big pharma or herbal?
Wait, did you just ask me big pharma or herbal?
Yes, I did.
I'm sorry. Have you had too many pots today?
I've had a few pots today.
That's straight up herbal.
Hunt or fish?
Well, I mean, I guess if you're going to put it like that, then I'd have to say hunt.
If you had Elon Musk money, what would your doomsday vehicle look like?
What would my doomsday vehicle?
Yep.
Yeah, I don't know. See, part of me wants to say a SR-71. Because I just get up there and fly faster than every motherfucker around, and then I ain't got to worry about you. But then I don't know. On the ground wise, I probably a Striker. Yeah. On a ground vehicle would be a Striker.
What is one vice that you know you have?
Oh, one vice. Damn, I can't believe I'd say it, but I'd probably say I'm too nice. I try too hard to correct myself.
What is one proud moment of your life? Not your kids, not your wife, no marriages, of your, like, your actual accomplishment.
Oh, shit, dude. Oh, man. I mean, that would probably be some kind of, I don't know, man. That's hard to really say. Because that connects. Hell, anybody I've ever pulled out of anything would be on that list. And I couldn't put one over another or nothing. But I guess accomplishment-wise, if I just went off accomplishments, it would be raising two kids.
Nope, kids don't. You can't say kids.
Well, no, but raising two kids. I went back to college, so I actually went and got my degree while I was raising two kids, and I actually finished with I was at a 4.0 GPA. I got a little award deal and shit, and that's a one. But because I don't know, dude.
That counts. It's not your most proudest moment. It's just any random moment that made you proud.
Well, yeah, because my most proudest, I don't shit. Dude, what do you do? Okay. How do you pick which person,
right,
out of which incident was that moment? I don't know.
If you could go and redraw the map of the entire globe right now, which country should be American owned?
Damn, just one?
Yep.
Canada.
What is the last picture that you took? Or the last picture you remember taking?
A galvanized cap. I took a picture of my computer so that my wife would know which aisle it was on in the store and what it looked like and how much it was supposed to cost.
Livestock garden or grocery store?
What? In my...
Like a market, something like that. Mm-hmm.
Like right here as is, right now, kind of pick one, it'd be garden.
Are you tired of supporting the Chi-Con economy? Don't trust China. China is asshole. Do you enjoy tiny little Asian hands sewing your shirts just so they can send them to other tiny little Asian hands that print those shirts on communist machines in a communist factory? Stop supporting commies. GhostDesigns.shop, an American continent-based product printed by hand in an American basement by a teacher, a soldier, a god... damn patriot. GhostDesigns.shop. Anything else? You're just killing Uyghurs.